Hi, I'm Laura Clark, coming to you from Jerry's Music in South Hadley, Massachusetts. So let's talk about stopping on the horn. It's a type of closing the bell, of muting to affect the sound. It can be done with a stopping mute, but when you put the stopping mute in, or later I'll show you how to do it with your hand, it's going to mean a different note comes out. So if I play third space C and I put the stopping mute in, that got a half step higher. There certainly are arguments about acoustically what's going on, but the way I like to remember it is pretend that you cut off the bell of the horn, it got smaller, a smaller horn goes higher, the pitch goes up a half step, so we as a horn player look at the note on the page and finger down a half step. Stopping really should be done on the F side of the horn, he says, the starting place, because the cutting the bell affects the F side of the horn more evenly. If you try to use a half step down fingerings on the B flat side of the horn, they don't always come out in tune. So I'm going to take out stopping mute. It's really good for making that buzzy sound, but there certainly are passages where the composer has asked for stopped horn that you don't have time to put a mute in and take it back out again, like this, from Rimsky-Korsakov Capriccio Espanol. So getting a mute in and out in that time would not have been easy. Instead, I used my hand. Another example. So certainly getting a mute in and out at that point would not have worked. I probably would have hit myself in the mouth as I tried to juggle the mute. So to do stopping with your hand, I'm going to take my hand, make that cup, and then I'm going to let the knuckles from my hand collapse in a little bit. Everyone's hand is different. Your hand may be smaller, it may be larger, it may be thinner, it may be beefier, but we're trying to seal the bell. We can't seal it completely, otherwise our head would explode. But we're going to try to stuff up the bell, plug it up. So I'm going to let my hand collapse just a little, keeping the thumb alongside. I'm going to turn it from that shape, push it in a little further, to an L as I pull it back out a little bit. Pushing here against the side of the bell towards me, pushing out against the opposite side of the bell with these fingers, and again, making sure that my thumb is alongside so there's no wormhole there for the air to come out before I want it to. So putting the hand in, letting it collapse just a little bit, then pulling back out to more of an L shape, pushing out with my fingers, pushing over with my palm. So that went up half step, so I'm going to finger down. Instead of fingering a C, I'm going to finger a B. And I'm blowing really hard to get that buzzy sound. And I have to say, I feel like I'm blowing down a bit to keep the pitch down. You'll see an exercise posted here that is alternating those open notes and closed notes, trying to match the pitch. And then rest. And you'll see those notes can be slippery as you're pushing lots of air. You want to keep a firm embouchure. And so on. That upper register and on up is actually easier on the stopping than the middle register. So if you want to check your hand position to see how nice and tight it is, go to middle C. And you'll see it fights back a lot more. So if you're doing low stopping, this mute works very nicely. So certainly for low horn players, you'll want to have a stopping mute. Bands might even want to own a stopping mute. Certainly where Van Hogel will want to own four of the regular street use that we talked about in the last video, at least four, for your four or five or six or eight horn players. So how do you know when to do stopping and when to do muting? Well, in the music, if it's muted, it will say, if the closer wants muted, they'll say muted, or consordino in Italian, avec sourdine in French, and gedämpft if they want it to be muted in a German score. That word holds until you see the word in that language for open, or normal, or natural. Sometimes it can say local, meaning as is, in location. So you keep the mute in. For stopping, on the other hand, the words will hold throughout a passage. So if you see the word stopped, or the international plus sign, that means stop. In Italian, it's chiuso. In French, it's bouché. In German, it's gestopft. So that all of those words will hold until the next passage. It may say open, aperto, ouvert, or often, but when the passage ends, then you go to open with those words. The stop sign, the international sign for stopping, plus, only applies to the note that it's over. So a composer, if they do it correctly, either puts a plus over every note they want stopped, or puts a plus and dash, 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 and to be clear, they'll often put a little O for open over the passage then when the stopping has ended.